this is some sort of way to keep time. It could be a stopwatch, it could be a clock on the wall, you could stop watching your phone, whatever you need, because you need something to keep 30-second intervals. So we're gonna do air squats for 30 seconds straight, nice steady cadence, and then your 30 seconds of rest is held at the bottom of the squat where your thighs are parallel. Don't completely bottom out to where you can just chill out on, you know, you're sitting on your calves and kind of just hanging out in the deep, deep bottom of the squat. Hold it so those thighs are parallel so we still got max tension on the legs, all right? So we're just gonna run through this for one round. Typically, this is done for at least 2 straight minutes. Then you'll rest 2 minutes and then you can hit another 2 minutes. Or what I usually program is 4 straight minutes of this. So 30 squat, 30 hold, 30 squat, 30 hold, 30 squat, 30 hold, 30 squat, 30 hold. And then you rest 2 minutes and do it again. All right, so this is something great. You can do this at the beginning of a squat workout to really pre-fatigue and warm up the legs, or you can do it at the end as a burnout. So we'll go ahead, we'll hit one round of this so you can kind of see how this looks. All right, so 30 seconds squat to start. Just a normal air squat, nice steady cadence. Go. I'm not trying to set any world records here. We're not trying to go super insane fast. Just a nice steady cadence of squats here. Make sure you're keeping your stopwatch handy so you can see. Mine makes noise for me. Now we hold. So we're gonna hold right at to where that those thighs are parallel to the ground. Put your arms out in front, try and keep that chest up best you can. And we just sit here and we hold. Try to maintain this position. And then we would go right back into 30 seconds of air squats and repeat that for the designated amount.